Hello students, hope you all are well. Let us start our next video on the basis of elements of accounts, standard 11, part 2. The last video I completed the fourth chapter, that is bills of exchange. And this video I'll start the fifth chapter, which is called Financial Statement of Business Organizations. It has the another name, which is called Final Account. In short form, in this chapter, oftenly we will say, rather than Financial Statement of Business Organization, Final Account or Annual Account. Page number 106 of your textbook, part 2, that is called Final Account or Annual Account. Before starting this chapter, first I will tell you the theoretical part. I will try to make you understand as much as possible. You pay attention for the theoretical part first, then slowly we will go to the practical sides. Before starting this chapter, I want to tell you, this is the most important chapter out of this all 22 chapters from your part 1 as well as the part 2. You are having total part 1 11 chapters and part 2 11 chapters. Total you are having 22 chapters. Out of these 22 chapters, this chapter is the most important chapters, and as long as you will be the student in commerce, that chapter will go with you. If you avoid this chapter, you will lose the maximum marks in your exam, because one questions in 11th standard, one questions, practical questions will come from this chapter, which will give you 11 to 12 marks. So be careful about this chapter. One more thing I want to tell you, the chapter which you are going to learn from this 11th standard, 100% D2 to D2 are there in the 12th standard. This final account is your company's final account, and in 12th standard you are going to learn the final account, that is called partnership final account. There is not much difference between this final account and 12th standard partnership final account. So if you learn it very well in 12th standard final account, when you will do next year, that you will be benefited for that. So pay attention very carefully about this chapter. Let you know the theoretical part of this chapter first. Final account means the annual account, I told. And whatever you have learned till now, that I will tell you several times to you, main four steps you are going to learn. That is, still now whatever you have learned before the final account of chapter 5, of part 2, you have completed 11 chapters from part 1 as well as the 4 chapters from part 2. That means 11 plus 4, 15 chapters you completed, and this is chapter number actually 16 if you count from 1. From part 1, 11 chapters, and this is 5th chapter, means 4th chapter you completed. And all these chapters still now, you could not find out how much is the profit or loss a business is earning. That still you could not learn. Businessmen, they are earning the money. They are getting the profit. Some of the businessmen, they are getting the loss. But how much a businessman is getting profit or how much a businessman is getting loss, still now not a single chapter you did not learn. The step 4, this is actually, the step 1 is called the journal, step 2 is called the ledger, this is trial balance, and this is called final account. Matlab, if you reach in this place, then you will be able to find out whether is getting businessman is getting profit or loss. It is not so easy to say by seeing the business physically. Physically by seeing the business, it is not easy to say whether his business is getting profit or loss. The paper will say, whatever you recorded, the transactions will say whether you are getting profit or loss. Journal is the first step of your business. Then you have learned the ledger. Then you have learned the trial balance. And now we are going to learn the final account. Already questions came in your mind that I completed total 15 chapters, but you have written here 4 chapters. Journal is one chapter, ledger is one chapter, trial balance is one chapter, and final account is another chapter. What about the remaining 11 chapters? Actually, in journal, from part 1, you are having total 11 chapters. Out of that, from chapter 1 to 8, I think so, all are journal only, journal related, different types of journal. Subsidiary books is also journal. Journal is first chapter, second chapter, third chapter, fourth chapter, fifth chapter, these all are journal. Sixth, I do not know, maybe cash book is also called journal. Journal proper is also called journal. And the chapter second step, that is ledger, is you are having a separate chapter, and trial balance you are having a separate chapter. That means from part 1, almost all the chapters except bank reconciliation statement, you have learned the journal, ledger and trial balance. And part 2, the rectifications of errors is also called journal. Depreciations, it is how to calculate the amount of depreciations, is related with the ledger and journal. Then bills of exchange is also a journal. Now the step where you are reaching, that is the place, is according to that, it is fourth step. I am telling you fourth step, the step 1, step 2, step 3 and step 4. Step 4, if you are able to complete, then you will be able to find out whether your business is getting profit or loss. Without learning this accountancy, it is not possible to find out if a business is getting profit or loss for a large-scale organizations. So let you know what is called final account and how you will do the final account. The final account means annual account. It has the 3 steps. Step 1, step 2, and step 3. What is the 3 steps? It is given it here. These 3 steps, theoretical part, first you learn, then practical part, I will go in details afterwards. This is step 1, this is step 2, this is step 3. All 3 together is called final account. This is called trading account. This is called profit and loss account. And this is called balance sheets. First 2 steps I wrote account, trading account and profit and loss account. Here I did not write account, here I wrote balance sheets. Balance sheet is not an account, for that we did not write anywhere in account. As this is an account, for it has the 2 sides, left hand side and right hand side, which is called debit sides and credit sides. Here you have to write debit credit, but don't write debit credit here. Now what type of questions you are going to get and how you will solve it? These 3 steps together is called final account. Balance sheet, it has 2 sides. One side is called left hand side, another is called right hand sides. And right hand side is called the asset sides and left hand side is called liability sides. This is amount, this is amount, this is amount, this is particulars, this is particulars, this is amount, this is particulars, this is amount, and this is particulars. What type of questions you are going to get, that you have to understand very carefully. You are going to get a question in the form of a trial balance. And what is called the trial balance? That is already known to you. Trial balance means it has the two sides. One is the debit side, another is the credit side. Page number 129, a complete sum is given. That sum I want to tell you first. After that I will come back the previous page. This is the illustration 4 of page number 129. This is your questions. Prepare an annual account of Krupa from her trial balance as on 31st 3 2015 mein aapko trial balance, sorry, final account banana hai. This is a trial balance. Trial balance of Krupa as on 31st 3 2015. As it is a trial balance, it has the two sides. One is the debit sides and another credit sides, or one is the debit column and another is the credit column. Here the amount, whatever it is given in the debit column, this is all a debit balance which you got from trial balance, and the balance, whatever you got it in the credit column, that is also a balance, but this all balance you got from trial balance, sorry, ledger. These are the balance you got from the ledger, and these are the balance you got from the ledger also. All this balance you got from the ledger, and this balance you got the debit balance, and this account you got the debit balance, and this account you got the credit balance. And your total of the trial balance, you see the 6 lakh both the sides. What you have to do, that whatever it is given inside that, all this inside the trial balance, this all account, this is called trial balance. And below the trial balance you may get one more things which is called adjustment. Say complete sum is, you will get a trial balance as well as you will get the adjustment. First of all, you have to know what you will do by taking these all accounts. After that I will tell you what you will do in the adjustment. These are the accounts you have to post. Matlab you have to write. Post means here, not the ledger posting. Posting means these are the accounts you have to post into the 6 places out of one place out of the 6 places. You see, the trading account debit side 1, trading account credit side 2, profit and loss account debit side 3, profit and loss account credit side 4, balance sheet liability side 5, and balance sheet asset side 6. So there are the, in this final account, the 3 steps, but you are having 6 places: trading account debit, trading account credit, profit and loss account debit, profit and loss account credit, balance sheet liability sides, and balance sheet asset sides. These all are the accounts. Out of the 6 places, it will go in any one places. Not a single account which is given either in the debit balance or it is in the credit balance, that will go out of these 6 places any one place. So you have to know first which account you will write where. Just example, if I say opening stock. Opening stock, where you will write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next is coming capital and drawings. Capital, where you will write. Drawings, where you will write. Building, where you will write. Machinery, where you will write. So we will start from the top to bottom. We'll start from the top and we'll reach to the bottom. And we will take decision that this will go out of the 6 places, which one places. Now how you will know which one will go where? First of all, this idea you should have. What idea? That debit balance means, trial balance, debit balance means either it is an expense or it is a loss or it is assets. Because you know that expense and losses and assets all are debit. And credit balance, whatever you know, or whatever you got, that is either it is income, gains, or liability. So whatever you are getting here, this is either it is an expense, or it is a loss, or it is assets. Or whatever you are getting it here, either it is an income, or it is a gain, or it is a liability. Now you know the assets and liability place, it is fixed. So assets will come in assets column, liability will come in liability column. Expense, this is expense and loss sides. This is expense or loss. This is also a expense or loss. This is income or gains, and this is also income or gains, and this is liability. This is assets. So here, if you get assets from here, that will go here. If you get liability, that will come hit here, because assets place is fixed, assets will come in debit column only, and liabilities place is fixed, that is liability will come credit column. Now question already it came in your mind, sir, here also you wrote expense and loss, here also you wrote expense and loss, here also you wrote incomes and gains, here also you wrote incomes and gains. So what type of expense will write it here, or what type of expense will write it here, or what type of income will write it here, or what type of income will write it here. When you will do the final account, that time you will keep in mind that you are the such type of business where you are having the two units. One is called the processing unit or manufacturing unit, production unit, and another is called office. So you are having the two places business is going on. You are doing business, but you think that you are having the manufacturing unit as well as the you are having the office. Office is controlling everything. Now the expense which you are doing for production unit or the manufacturing unit, or loss, whatever you are getting from the production unit or manufacturing unit, that are called direct expense. Just if I say the example, you can understand what is called the direct expense. Suppose you paid wages to the worker. Worker means those who are working in the factory, they are called worker. And remunerations, whatever you are paying to the worker, is called wages. And some of the people, they are working in the office, you are paying them salary. The salary is also a remuneration against the work. Wages also a remuneration against the work. But wages you are paying to the worker, salary you are paying to the employee. Wages is your direct expense, which is related to the factory, but salary is your indirect expense, which is related to your office. So I will tell you, when you will do the trading account, that time here I wrote the direct expense and loss, which is related to the factory, manufacturing unit. Manufacturing unit se jo expense hota hai, jo loss hota hai, that will come in trading account debit sides. Similarly, manufacturing unit se jo income hota hai or gains hota hai, that will go to the trading account credit side. This is called direct expense, this is called direct income. Just a sale. Sale is your direct income. So purchase is your direct expense, purchase of raw material. So factory related expense and income. Factory related expense and factory related income, that will come trading account debit side as well as the trading account credit side. Similarly, it is called the factory related. Correct? And this is office related. Office related expense is called indirect expense. Or loss, that will come here. Just two wages is here, but two salary is here. So this is called indirect income. Just interest from the bank. You are getting the interest from the bank, or you are getting the interest from any other investment, not from the sale. By selling the goods, the income, whatever it is coming, that is coming in the trading account credit sides. But apart from that, selling the goods, goods if you sell, that income will come. Apart from the selling of the goods, if you get any other income, generally that comes in the trading account, not trading account, profit and loss account credit sides. So keep in mind, this is the expense and losses which is related with the office. This is the expense and incomes and gains which is related to the office. So factory related expense and income, this is office related expense and income. And this is the liabilities, whatever the liability businessman is having, and this is the assets, whatever the assets businessman is having, that you keep in mind. This is the overall idea I have given you, how you will do the posting first. After doing the posting, before that, so many things I have to tell you one by one, all I'll say. But one more thing you have to keep in mind. Trading account I wrote, profit and loss account I wrote, but balance sheets account I did not write. Whenever you will write in the trading account debit sides, whatever the account, you will write TO2, two opening stock, two purchase, two wages, or two any other things here. Whatever you will write it decides that you will write buy, because it is an account. Similarly, profit and loss account, whatever you will write in debit side, you will write two. Profit and loss account, whatever you will write in the credit side, you will write buy. But balance sheets, assets and liability, don't write two and buy, because balance sheet is not an account. Now, question already it came in your mind. Sir, illustration 4 you are taking, what about the illustration 1, 2? This is incomplete sum. Let me give some idea from a complete sums. After that, I will come back one by one, all these things. Or already question came in your mind, sir, how I will know which is assets and which is liability, or which is direct expense, which is indirect expense, or which is direct income or which is indirect income. If I do one or two illustrations, then automatically you will come to know which is direct, indirect, expense, loss, everything, it is given it here. Apart from that, in your textbook, the trading account debit side as well as the trading account credit side, whatever the accounts is coming, that is page number 110, it is given details. Trading account debit sides, what are the direct expense it may come, and trading account credit sides, whatever the direct income it may come. One or twice you go through, you will come to know. One second, I am reading page number 110, the trading account it is given, and page number profit and loss account is 115, details about the profit and loss is given, and balance sheet also you will get one more page where everything it is given regarding details about the balance sheets. Whatever the balance sheets, debit side, asset sides as well as the liability sides, it is coming. That is which page will come to know afterwards, what page number I will tell you. So first you come trading account debit sides. Trading account debit sides, page number 110, if you read 10 and 110 and 115, I am writing it here. Trading account, that is page number 110. Profit and loss account, that is page number 115. These two pages first you follow. After that I will come. Trading account debit sides means direct expense, opening stock, purchase, less purchase return, less goods going out other than sales. Suppose if you are going out goods other than the sales, then that you have to deduct from purchase. Expense related to the purchase, wages, carriage inward, railway freight. Ek do bar aap padho to aapko sab pata chal jayega trading account debit side mein generally which are coming. Wages, carriage inward, railway freight, octroi, custom duty, lorry freight, port charges, dock charges, clearing charges, demurrage, demurio, and that is karajat expense, that is water fare, what fare, etc. And expense related to the productions, beverage. That is productive wages, royalty, factory expense, rent, taxes, power, fuel, coal, gas, that is material consumed, oil and grease, depreciation of the factory building, depreciation on plant and machinery, gross profit. I know that one, it is not possible to remember this all, but one or twice if you read, at least you will, your mind will click that this item, it was there in the trading account debit side. These are the all called the direct expense or loss. This is called direct incomes or gains. Sales, less sales return, less sale of scrap goods, then closing stock and gross loss. Gross loss and gross profit both will not come together. Page number 115, it is given profit and loss account. These are all are coming in the profit and loss account debit sides. But in the one sum, this all will not come. That when you will do the sum, few of them will come. Primary one or two illustration you do, after that you will come to know. First of all, gross loss, or this side gross profit, both will not come. Either it will come gross profit or it will come gross loss. These are the balance it's coming from the previous step, which is called the trading account. Trading account ka balance jo hai, wo either gross profit ho ke aayega aur gross nahi to gross loss ho ke aayega. Gross profit ho aayega to credit mein likhna hai, profit and loss account mein, aur gross loss hoga to debit mein likhna hai. Salary, allowance, bonus, rent, insurance premium, taxes, postage, stationery and printing expense, legal expense, audit fees, electricity expense, repairing expense and maintenance expense, contribution to the provident fund, contribution to the employee state insurance, that is staff welfare expense, staff training expense, this is carriage outward, salary of the salesmen, commissions of the salesmen, traveling expense of the salesmen, advertisements expense, discount allow, delivery van expense, discount reserve, to exhibitions participations expense, to showroom expense, go down expense, packing expense, interest on the capital, interest on bank overdraft, interest on borrowed loan, to bank charges and bank commissions. And these are the coming the profit and loss account carry side, which is called the indirect income apart from the sale of the goods. That is gross profit, I already told you, by discount receipts, rent receipts, commission receipts. If you receive the discount, if you receive the rent, if you are having the extra room you have given for the rent, like that. Brokerage receipts, commission receipts from the consignor, interest on investment, interest on loan given, interest on drawing, bad debt return. This all I will say one by one when you will do the practical sum in details. Bad debt return, what is called profit on sales of the assets, sales of the old newspaper, sale of scrap, miscellaneous income, etc., appendices premium and net loss. Here the balance, whatever you will get, either you will get the net profit or you will get the net loss. The balance, whatever you are getting from the trading account, that you have to transfer to the profit and loss account. Trading account, you may get the balance either the gross profit or you may get the gross loss. If you get the gross profit, it will come the profit and loss account credit side. If you get the gross loss, it will come the profit and loss account debit sides. Similarly, from this account also you will get the balance. If you make difference between these two columns, you will get the balance. And the balance, whatever you will get, either it will be the net profit or it will be the net loss. If you are getting the net profit, the next steps it will be transferred, which is called the balance sheets. And if you are getting the net profit, it will be added with the capital. If you are getting the net loss, it will be deducted from the capital. For this side also it is there. In the page number 116, profit and loss account debit side, still few items are there. Donations, depreciations on the assets, bad debt from adjustment, bad debt reserve from the adjustment, then bad debt reserve from the trial balance, loss by fire, loss by theft, loss on sale of the fixed assets, to loss on sale of the investment, the provisions for expense and loss, last is coming net profit. Practical sums when you will do, that time I will go in details. Just here you come to know, whatever you will write it here and whatever you will write it here, first of all we will find out the difference. And difference generally, maximum cases, here you are getting gross profit, GP. That is, you have to write two gross profit transfer to the profit and loss account. And that GP, you will write it here by transfer from profit and loss account, sorry, trading account. That balance, suppose here you are getting 60,000, the 60,000 balance you will write it here. And again, same like that, you will make the total of these two column. and generally maximum cases you will get the net profit. And whatever the net profit you are getting from the profit and loss account, that you have to write, you have to add with the capital, add NP. Capital account will write it first, NP will write it, then final amount will write it here. This is the system to do it. Theoretical part I told, next video, I want to show you how practically you are doing posting and you are doing the adjustment. So you follow that one video at least twice and try to understand. Even though at any place if you do not understand, you can tell me. The page number 110 and page number 115, I told you. Page number 1, second I want to tell you. Page number 110 and page number 115. And balance sheet also you are having one more page that I will tell you, that you have to go through so that you can understand whatever is coming in the trading account debit side as well as the trading account credit sides and profit and loss account debit side as well as the profit and loss account credit sides. If you make practice one or two sums, automatically you will find out the next sum onwards that 80 to 85% are common. Okay, bye, all the best.